We wanted to start this virtual walk, as we've mentioned before, with the place that almost everyone here is a student of Selamers. We wanted to start with the place that's most, approachable, most closest to you all. So some of you must have noticed the different life forms other than the busy humans running to classes in the packed 5-hour span. But most of us tend to be unaware of all the beauty around us on campus amidst our busy schedules. So I've been in Sella only for a year now, and I honestly have gotten only a handful of opportunities to go around the campus and be fascinated with all that our campus hosts. And today I'll just be sharing a bit of what I've come across on campus and what you can look for when we go back to campus. So here's a map of our campus. And yes, it's been a year, and yes, I still get confused between the names of the blocks. So let's have a flashback to our college and take a walk through it. So obviously, where do we start from? We start from the main gate. So as soon as we enter college, we see the pretty Star Garden. And around the last 3 months of when we did go to college, that is around January to March, you might have noticed 4 to 5 white birds with black and yellow legs early in the morning walking and feeding in the garden. So those are nothing but the cattle egrets in their non-breeding plumage. So early in the morning, you'll find them, the cattle egrets, and you'll also find the common mynah and pigeons in groups, not to mention that they're everywhere else too. You'll find the mynah and squirrel nests on trees and near buildings, and you'll also definitely find small damselflies among the smaller plants in the garden. An occasional visitor to the Star Garden is also the shikra. This is a picture of a puffed up shikra sitting outside the zoology lab during our practicals, captured by our professor Vidya ma'am. So the next place we'll be looking at is the canteen. So what's the one bird that you'll instantly think of when you hear the word canteen? So I don't think one person from Stella can get this wrong. It's definitely the Stella crows. At least 70% of the college has been attacked by our crows. So since we know them so well, I thought let's tell you that there are two different types of crows on campus: the house crow that's on the left and the large-billed crow that's on the right. But other than these crows, what else do we get to see on campus? So this is a picture of all the crows sitting together. But from right where you'd sit, holding on to your food or canteen snacks, whether it's on the benches beneath the big tree or under the shelter, hiding from the crows, if you focus on the large tree that's very obviously there, you'll notice two tree hollows, and from these hollows would be heads popping out. Make sure you don't get too obviously close that they go back in. But these are the spotted owlets in the tree between around the months December to March. And you'll also find the rose-ringed parakeets. No need to mention, they're there all year long. You'll also find small, cute, pretty bugs like the jewel bug on some plants nearby. So the next place from the canteen, where do we walk? Towards the NCC ground. And walking towards the far end of the NCC ground, without disturbing the NCC cadets, of course, you'll find again the spotted owlet glaring at you with its round eyes. And this time during January, we also spotted the Asian brown flycatcher. If you look a little higher, there are these leafless set of branches that of a tree that we call the visitor's tree. You'll always find a certain visitor there. And we've seen the brown shrike and the blue-tailed bee eater on that tree. You'll also find the coppice with barbet there. And if you look up in the sky, there's almost always a chance that you'll see a black kite flying in circles looking for food. The tawny coaster butterfly is also one of my favorites, found near the basketball court, and it is found in pretty good numbers there. The next place will be the Santa Sofia block, the SS block. So we have a couple of trees with big colorful flowers in front of the SS block. And these are known to attract sunbirds and tailor birds. These are small birds that keep moving, barely sit still on trees, and have a pretty loud, rapid call despite their size. If you ever reach college early, just stand between SS Block and the Green Hut, and you'll definitely hear one of them call and also get to see them. So, what are we looking at now? This is one of the famous after college hangout spots, the Green Hut. We all know that the Green Hut is surrounded by quite a bit of greenery, and there's one bird there's no way you would have never seen from the Green Hut, which are the parakeets. So you definitely would have noticed the rose-ring parakeets flying or screeching around the Green Hut. But if you actually look up at the rain tree, you'll find so many either sitting in pairs or alone, sleeping or grooming, peeping out of tree hollows. And it's such an interesting sight to watch. You'll also find the black-rumped flameback or the woodpecker sitting on the tree drumming into the bark. The woodpeckers usually fly between the Green Hut and the NCC ground, and there's a high chance of seeing them around these areas. The pavements we have around the Green Hut for walking on are slabs that have small gaps between and under them. And around these areas, actually towards NCC ground and near hostels, you'll find the Indian grey mongoose. And also our campus does have snakes. They just don't come out during the day while we are around. I've never gotten a chance to see them yet. So the next place we'll be going to is near the Maggie Station, between the Maggie Station and the B Block. You'll find a small lawn from where the butterfly sightings start. So you'll find butterflies like the crimson rose, the mormon, the pretty jezebel, and small lime blues resting somewhere nearby. You'll also find the rufous tree pie with their long tails sitting on trees there. Now, the next place is the place I love the most on campus, and it's the area that connects between the OAT to Snehalaya Hostel to the B Block. This is a sight one can never have missed while passing through this area. You might not notice it if you're in a hurry, but if you actually stop and focus a little above eye level, it's a beautiful sight of so many butterflies sitting in lines and clusters on branches of trees, especially the blue tigers and dark blue tigers and the common crow butterflies. These are pictures captured in mid-July last year, and it's an absolutely mesmerizing sight to watch. So now walking behind the B Block towards the White Hut, there's this one guy who catches my eye all the time, and that is the garden lizard. Picture in the is the garden lizard in its breeding colors, so in bright red, yellow, black markings. You would have seen them doing this push-up type of action. That's their way of warming their blood up after the cold night, since they're cold-blooded animals. Also, they do it to attract mates. You'll also see the plains cupid, the lemon pansy, striped tiger butterflies, and if you notice, the lemon pansy has spots that look like eyes, and they're called eye spots. They help in deceiving the predators. There's also the crimson rose. This picture, it took us half an hour to get the butterfly to sit, but it's such a beautiful butterfly. So between the White Hut and the chapel, you'll definitely find the Indian palm squirrel running cautiously up and down the tree, yelling at the Asian koel that's always there in the tree. So this is the female Asian koel in the picture. You'll also find the white-throated kingfisher perched at a height, and the egg fly, female butterfly, and many other butterflies for that matter. And it's a good catch there. Now moving on to the place that gives us a lot of different butterflies, and the NN Block. So the NN Block, with its beautiful garden in front of it, is one of the best spots during the season to find many different butterflies flying around or resting, including the blue pansy, the painted lady, and the common leopard, among many others. So these are just a few of what we've seen on campus during the season. Yeah, this too. So here's just showcasing some of the best of what I've been able to capture: the peacock pansy, the egg fly, the spotswort tail, and there's so much for us to see on campus. We don't even notice sometimes, but then it takes only like a little bit, 2 minutes of our time to actually stand and look, and there's so much around us. So, well, that's pretty much only a part of all the beautiful fauna you can find on campus. So next time you go around campus, whenever we get to do that, that is, don't forget to look around a bit and be fascinated by all the life forms around us. Do remember, always observe, never disturb. And I hope you found this relatable and it gives you a base on what to look for on campus. Thank you for listening. I shall now pass it on to the next speaker. Thank you very much.